Medical experts say the dietary deficiencies in Ethiopia not only lead to malnutrition among children, but also pose a great danger to the unborn. Many women of childbearing age are ignorant of the need to eat foods like green leafy vegetables, beans and citrus fruits, all of which are rich in folic acid. As a result, experts say they have seen increasing cases of children born with birth defects.
Because of this deficiency, there is a congenital malformation which causes significant disability for newborn babies, what we call neural tube defect. Neural tube defect is a disease which affects the brain and the spinal cord. And this is happen congenitally while the baby is on the first weeks, 4 weeks of consumption of the baby.
The country has no specific data yet on how many such cases exist countrywide, but medical experts say the number is high. A new pediatric neurosurgery department at the St. Peter's Specialized Hospital in Addis Ababa is the second in the country, assisting to correct neurotube defects among children.
This hospital like opened the neurosurgery department 1 year back. So in these years, and that we operated more than 350 kids with neural tube defects. So imagine how we can support with the campaign and acceptance of the service.
However, it is still a challenge for less specialized medical experts to effectively address the problem.
The Ministry of Health is, you know, supporting the university hospitals to teach more graduates in the neurosurgery. And in fact, for a population of like around 100 million, only 30 neurologists is not enough. So we are working on like improving the number and the mix of like senior neurosurgeons in this country.
The Ethiopian government is now looking at prevention. It has launched a countrywide campaign to create awareness on folic acid consumption. Medical experts say one of the best preventive measures is for females between the ages of 14 and 49 to start taking at least 0.4 milligrams of folic acid supplements every day. These tablets, however, are not easily accessible in Ethiopia. So the best advice for now is to eat food rich in folic acid, which is available. Coletta Wanjohi, CGTN, in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia.